Hello everyone and welcome back, it's Vicky here and the new Tonic Craft Kit has been released, so today we are going to take a close-up look on what's included and I'm also going to share three projects. Now the kit, just like every month, is packed with wonderful Nouveau products. So first of all, you get a mini glimmer paste in Moonstone color. I'm going to open it up for you and hopefully you will see how shiny that is. This is actually a paste that has glitter inside and you can apply it on your projects with a spatula. Now I'm going to show you the actual size, but in the kit you get a mini size, which is perfect if you want to try it out. Now I go through these jars a lot. This is my favorite color of all the glimmer pastes, just because it actually picks up the color of your project. And if you want to buy just one color of glimmer paste to test it out, then I would definitely suggest to try out the Moonstone. So I'm going to apply it with my spatula over a black cardstock and hopefully you will be able to see the shine. And I'm also going to apply it over white cardstock so you can see that it works both ways. I'm going to leave those aside to dry and we will get back to those later so you can see all the shine. In the kit you get two mini Nouveau drops. I'm going to swatch them out for you. So this is Dazzling Blue and it contains glitter, and this one is Liquid Mercury and it is metallic. Now in the kit you will also get a full-size Mica Mist in a beautiful blue color. This Mica Mist is actually very shiny. You can use it as I'm going to do it here, just to add splashes on your projects, or you can just spray all over your project, which is going to give a beautiful shine. So I'm going to spray on this scrap piece of white paper and all over my surface because I was too lazy to bring a box underneath. I'm going to try and catch the light for you because this is really shiny. Just make sure that you swipe the nozzle before you put it away, otherwise this mica might clog your nozzle. Now I'm also going to try it on a darker colored cardstock and you will see that it goes beautifully on top of it and it gives that beautiful shine. And this is a glitter pot, it contains silver glitter, which is perfect for your winter cards and your Christmas cards. And let's take a look at the dies and the stamp set for this month. So, as always, you get a sticker, which I'm always sticking it at the front of my folder, just for the fun of it. And this is the stamp set, let's take a close-up look. So you get stars and snowflakes. This is a clear stamp set and it has a lovely wave, so it is perfect for winter and Christmas cards. Now I am going to bring in the folder with the dies, and again the kit is packed with dies, just like always. Now you get 10 dies in total, but let's take a look first at this one. This is actually a gift card holder, so you are going to cut it out and fold it in half and you can add inside your gift card or some money. Now there are other dies, 4 more dies that fit inside. You can use those to decorate your gift card holder, or you can use them completely separately, and I will show you an example in this video. Now these dies are actually going to create a little box where you can add inside your gift card holder. So if you put this together, you will end up with a little box that has a slit on top and you can slide inside the holder. Now there are again 4 more dies to decorate your gift box. You get some of them with straight lines, others with stitching, and you also get 2 of them that will give you your sentiments. One of them says birthday wishes and this is Merry Christmas. Now remember, the dies and the stamps are exclusive to this kit and you cannot get them separately. Now let's take a look at the cardstock that you get in the kit. So you get 3 different colors. The first one is a pearlescent one and this is called Navy Dazzle. This is French blue, nice and sturdy. And finally you get this specialty paper, which is called crushed metal, and you get this lovely embossing. But that's not all when it comes to cardstock. They have also included this pad. This is a 6x6 pad with cardstock, and this is not a pattern paper thick paper pad. It is actually cardstock that's 230 GSM. They are 6x6 in size. They are all specialty papers with lovely shine. You get 4 different designs, 6 pages for each design. And the fact that you get 6 of each design is perfect because you don't have to hoard them. You can use them as much as your heart desires. So these are the contents of the craft kit. Now let's go back to the glimmer paste, which is completely dry now. I can rub my finger over it and the glitter doesn't go away. It is nicely set there. And hopefully you can see how shiny it is. This is a beautiful product. And I have actually used this product in previous projects many times. But that's not all. Don't forget that in every craft kit, every month you get a mystery gift. And this month the mystery gift has been actually revealed by Tonic just because they wanted to show you what kind of a gift you might get in one of those kits. This is not going to be revealed for the next kits, just for this month. So I'm going to show it to you. You get a full pack of glitter markers in Midnight Shadows color, as you can see the 3 colors here that complement the colors of the whole craft kit. Now I'm going to swatch them out for you and hopefully you will be able to see how beautifully and shiny they are. Now you need to prepare them the first time you open them, just shake them and then press the nib down. The ink is going to flow through the tip and you will be able to get that beautiful shine. As I am preparing the marker, I haven't sped up the video, so this is in real time. So you can see now that the ink has went all the way down to the tip and I can write down. Now I'm going to tilt the paper and catch the light and hopefully you can see how shiny this is. Now I did the same thing for the other 2 markers and here are the lovely colors and the beautiful shine. Now I'm going to show you another way of how you can use these markers. You can write down on your glass mat or on a slick surface. You can dilute it with water and then work with it as if it is watercolor. But remember that this has shine on it, so when it dries you will get a beautiful shiny color. I used one of the cardstocks from the kit and I created my card base and I'm going to pick the white card from the pad and I'm going to use one of the dies. Now the die that I'm using is supposed to create a little box with a slit on top. However, I'm not going to use it as a box, I'm just going to create a little pocket that lays completely flat on the front of my card. So I'm going to cut out my piece. And now I'm going to use this part that I have already cut out and I only want to use 3 of the flaps. So I'm going to fold 2 of those and now for the rest that I don't need, I'm just going to use my scissors and chop them out. Now if you use the Tonic Studio's official website, you will find how you can put this box together and there are other videos on YouTube where you can see how this is done. So I decided to try something different with this die just to give you another idea on how you can use it. So you can see I have 3 flaps. I'm going to add double-sided tape on each of those flaps and then stick it directly on top of my card base. Now you will see that at the top I have a little slit where I can fit inside the little gift card holder that I'm going to create with the other die. So now I'm going to pick another paper and I went with this beautiful silver one. I'm going to place on top this die and you can see it doesn't fit, but if you put it diagonally it fits perfectly fine there. And the good thing about this die is that it's not only cutting out, but it also creates the score lines for you. I used my bone folder to fold it in half and you can see that my little gift card holder is ready. And here is how it looks with the gift card inside, or you can add the money if you wish so. Now I'm going to decorate it a little bit more. You can tie some ribbon at the top or add some thread. I decided to tie this in a kind of a different way, as if it is a present. So I am wrapping it all around. I'm going to tie a little bow at the top. And it's ready to slide it inside the pocket. Now I'm also going to decorate the outside a little bit more. So first, let's add the sentiment. This is going to be a birthday gift card. So I'm going with the one that says birthday wishes. And as you can see, it doesn't cut out all around, but there are dies to do so if you wish. There is one with straight lines and another one with a little stitching. Now I'm going to show you another way that you can use these. So you can actually separate the sentiment out of the whole design. I'm going to use my scissors here. And here is one way of how you can use the sentiment, or you can even use a bigger scissor. You can see here I'm just trying to separate the bottom line, so the word wishes is completely free of that design. And I'm also going to use a bigger scissor, and I'm going to show you that you can also separate the top from the lines. So you can use it this way, or you can take it a step further and just separate the two words. So I am going to end up having only the word wishes. Just wanted you to see that this is really versatile. There are so many different ways to use it. It's the same die, but you can get totally different designs. And of course you can leave the card design as it is, plain and simple, or if you want you can take it a step further as I did and just die cut some stars. I did have a little star die, and you will find everything I'm using linked down below just like always. I'm using foam squares at the back of my stars, and I'm just going to embellish my card a little bit more. And I'm going to finish it off with the crystal drops that was included in the kit. And here is the finished card and some close-up photos. And in those close-up photos you can see the papers better. And also I love that the sentiment says just wishes, which means that it can be used for more occasions than just birthdays. Now let's move on to the second card for today. And for that I'm going to use this die, which is supposed to decorate the front of your gift card holder, but instead I'm going to create a little panel to put in front of my card. I'm going to use this gorgeous pattern paper, and I'm going to place the die on top, secure it with a piece of tape. I'm going to run it through my Big Shot, and now I'm going to lift the die, do some cleaning. Just need to pop out all these little pieces and also clean my plates. And now I'm going to die cut again, so I need to align these dots at the bottom of my pattern, secure it with a tape, and then run it again through my Big Shot. And I can create a really long pattern, as long as I like it to be. Now if you are very careful with the placement, you will end up with a completely seamless design. I was a little bit in a hurry, and you will be able to see that it's not perfect in the middle, but that's not really a problem since I am going to cover up the middle completely. So now I'm going to use my rectangle die and just cut out a panel, and this rectangle die is not included in the kit. You can always use your paper trimmer to do so. And now I have a little panel that would be beautiful in front of a card, and it is so stunning. The paper is so glittery and has that beautiful design, so it really makes a card on its own. And again, I'm going to combine it with this beautiful silver card. I am cutting it to size, so this is 4.25 by 5.5. I used my white ribbon, wrapped it around my panel, and now I'm tying a bow. And this is going to provide the perfect disguise for that little mistake that I have at the seam in the middle. And I can stick this panel on top of my silver cardstock with foam squares at the back. The design is very simple, but it looks really stunning in real life just because we used those beautiful papers. Now I have cut out two banners. One is out of the same silver cardstock as the back of my card, and I have also embossed the sentiment that says with love on vellum, and I have stuck one on top of the other. I'm going to tuck them just underneath my bow. Now you can use any sentiment that you have on your stash. I decided to go with the one that says with love just because it is very versatile and I can use it for lots of occasions. And now let's move on to the last card for today. And I couldn't create a set of cards without a shaker card, so let's create one of those. I have picked one of my papers. I'm going to place on top the Merry Christmas die, secure it with some tape and run it through my Big Shot. I'm working at the back of my panel where I have added some double-sided tape all around my window, and I'm going to place on top my acetate. I'm going to add my confetti inside. As you can see, I have already used my foam tape to create a little pocket there. And with my handy spoon, I added Diamond Harlequin, which is from the Pure Sheen Confetti Collection. Now I'm removing the backing and I'm going to completely cover up everything with my paper there. And this is where I changed my mind on the design. So I chopped off the bottom and I ended up with this smaller window. And you can see that I'm using as my card base one more of the papers included in the kit. I'm going to add my tape runner at the back and stick one on top of the other. And as you can see that I have already used my white ribbon and tied a little bow. So if you see the three cards together, you will see that they have the same elements, such as the papers and the white ribbon, and they can create a lovely set of cards. And again, to finish off my card, I'm going to use the mini glitter drops that was included in the kit. And I'm also going to add one from my stash, just to add some white dots as well. And I'm also going to give my card three white berries. I'm going to stick this panel on top of a standard card that's 4.25 by 5.5, and I have a finished card ready to go. And here is my complete set of three cards. I hope you had fun, that you got inspired. Don't forget that you can find the full list of all the supplies that I used down below in the description area, as well as on my blog. The kit will be available to order until the 31st of August, and you will find all the details about the kit and where you can order depending on where you live on my blog. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see you next time.